Hello, I welcome all the students for the lecture series of subject Theory of Computation. In the last lecture, we have seen that PDA is classified into two important types. One is DPDA, stands for deterministic pushdown automata, and another is a NPDA, stands for non-deterministic pushdown automata. Now, under the non-deterministic pushdown automata, there is an important topic that is nothing but equivalence of PDA and CFG. What is the equivalence of PDA and CFG? Equivalence of PDA and CFG, it means that if you are given with the context programmer, now what is context programmer? We have discussed in the last unit. In unit number 3, we have seen what is context programmer. Now, if you are given with the context programmer, how to construct the PDA for the context programmer, that we have to see. If you remember in the first lecture of unit number 4, we have seen that PDA can accept or it can recognize the context free language. What does it mean? It means that the language generated with the help of CFG is the context free language, and the PDA can accept or recognize the context free language. What does it mean? It means that we can construct the PDA for the context free language. So, here is one example. Construct the PDA for the following context free grammar. Construct PDA for the following context free grammar, and you are given with one grammar where production rules are E produces E star E, E produces E plus E, and E produces small e. You are given with this context free grammar and you need to construct the PDA for this context free grammar. Now, while constructing the PDA, the process of construction of PDA for this context free grammar is very simple. You just need to recall the concept of derivation process. You just need to recall the concept of derivation process. What do you mean by derivation process? Like, if I want to derive one string, which string? Like A plus A star A. If this is the string which you want to derive, for that particular purpose, what is expected? You will start from E produces. Means, first of all, you will consider starting symbol E. That starting symbol E, you will replace. That starting symbol E, you will replace by what? You will replace by E star E, means you will be writing E star E. Now, either by using leftmost derivation or by using rightmost derivation, you will be replacing. Now, this you can replace with E plus E and star E, and similarly this E will get replaced with A, again this E will get replaced with A, and this last E will also will get replaced with A. Like this way you can derive the string. That is so simple. Now, important thing is what? How to construct the PDA for this particular grammar, context free grammar. So, for that case, we will see the construction of PDA for the given grammar. What we will do? We will start from the initial state. Okay, start. I will be writing here start. Okay, then what I need to do, as this is the starting symbol, so I will push that starting symbol into the stack. Because unless and until I will not push it, I will not pop it, and when I pop it, I will be replace that E with the right hand side of the production rule. Getting? So, I will push that E into the stack. At the same time, I have to pop that E from the stack. Pop E. Okay, I will say it as a 1, pop 1. Okay, I will pop that E from the stack. When I pop that E from the stack, right hand side of that E, that is E star E, try to understand. Initially stack is empty. Initially stack is empty. I'll push that E into the stack. Now I have to pop that E from the stack. When I pop that E from the stack, the right hand side of that production rule will get pushed into the stack. Means E star E, that will get pushed into the stack. So what is required? I'll be writing, I'll pop E from the stack, and when I pop E from the stack, I'll push E. I'll push star, and I'll push once again E into the stack. I'll push, when I pop this first E, I'll push E star E into the stack, and again I'll come back to the pop state. Again I'll come back to the pop state. Now this is applicable when I want to replace E with E star E. But if I want to replace E with E plus E, then it is also possible that I want to replace E with E star E, or if I want to replace E with E plus E, so that is also possible. So you can do this by writing push E, again push plus, and at the end push E, and again you can come back to the initial, that is to the pop state. Okay, now check, E you have replaced with E plus E, or E you can replace with the, means that you can push E plus E or E star E. Now what I want, now you check, now I want to pop this E, I want to pop. Now if you look at the right hand side of the production rule, you can push here plus also, you can push here star also, as well as yes, plus and star. So you need to pop that plus and star also. At the same time, when you pop E, you need to replace that E with A also. A is the terminal. So in that case, what we can do, in that case what we can do, we can pop E, we can pop E, and we can read. When we pop E, we can read here. I'll say read one, and what you are going to read, you are going to read small a. Similarly, when we pop E, you can read here, that is read 2, and you can read instead of E, you can see, you can pop plus operator, as whatever the plus operator you have pushed into the stack, whatever the plus operator you have pushed into the stack, you can pop that plus from the stack, that time you will read the plus. And similarly, same is applicable for the, same is applicable for the star operator, read 3, so you can read the star. And again after this, again you can come back to the pop state. Like this way you will pop E plus star from the stack. Now let us check, let us create one, or let us derive one string with the help of this particular PDA. Is it possible to derive a string with the help of this PDA or not? Let us check. Let us consider the string, that is A plus A star A. Is it possible for me to derive this string A plus A star A with the help of this particular PDA? Yes, it is possible. How? You just check. I'll just push E into the stack. I'll start here. I'll push E into the stack. I'll push E into the stack. Initially stack is having blank. I'll push E into the stack. Fine. Now that E, I'll pop that E. I'll pop that E. So by using which rule I'll pop that E? Either first or second, whatever. So let us consider, I'll pop that E by using E star E. So I'll pop that E and I'll push E star E. These are the content of stack. Fine. Now again I'll come here and I'll say pop. Now this E I have to pop, only this E, huh? Because E plus E star E, again I'll come to the pop state. Now I have to pop first E, which is there on the top of the stack, this E. So when I pop this E, I have to push E plus E. I have to push E plus E. Look at here, blank. Initially this is E, then star. Now I have to pop this E. This E I am going to pop with E plus E. This much. Okay. This much. Fine. So E plus E. Again I will come back to pop 1 state. At pop 1, now I have to pop this E through this direction. Pop E with what? This small a. With what? This small a. I will pop this E. When I pop this E, I will read small a. When I pop this E, I will read small a. Fine. Then after that, blank E star E plus. Again I will come to pop 1 state. Now what is there to the top? What is there to the top of the stack? Top of the stack there is a plus. So I will pop this plus. I will pop this plus and I will read plus. I will read plus. After popping this plus, again I will come back to the pop 1 state. Again I have to pop this E. Now that E I will pop and I will read with what? A. This A I will read. Again I will come back to pop 1 state. Now this time what is there on the top of the stack? Star is there. So I will pop star and I will with the help of read 3 I will read the star. Check here, I will read the star. Okay. Now again I will come back to the pop 1 state. This time I have to pop last E. So when I pop that last E, I will read small a. I will read small a. Again I will come to the pop 1 state. So now what is there to pop? Blank is there to pop. So as blank is there to pop, so pop 1 will pop blank. When pop 1 is pop blank, so what is there to read? Blank is there to read. So I will say here, it is going to read, read 1, 2, 3, read 4, and read 4 is also going to read the blank. Read 4 is also going to read the blank, because the stack is empty. Read 4 is going to read blank. So it is what? Accepted by the given PDA. So if you look at this particular PDA, this is the PDA for the context free grammar. PDA for context free grammar. Now if you look at this particular PDA, this is the type of NPDA. This is the type of NPDA, non-deterministic push down automata. How this is the type of NPDA? If you look at pop 1 state, if you look at pop 1 state, there are 3 transitions for same input. There are 3 transitions for same input. It is not deterministic, it is non-deterministic. Means when I come to pop 1, I will be get confused that whether I have to go to this transition or this transition or this transition. E for same unique for unique input symbol, if there are more than one transitions, then that type of automata is what, or that type of automata is called as the non-deterministic push down automata. So like this way we can construct the PDA for the given context free grammar. So I hope you understand like how we can construct the PDA for the given context free grammar. So thank you all of you for watching my video. Thanks a lot.